Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's session on shifts in teaching learning system in pre and post COVID lockdown era. After conducting three successful sessions, today we are in day five. Being the academic coordinator of Nopani Institute of Management Studies, now I'm going to start today's session. Being beside a grand introduction with worthy conclusion, hereby I am happy to announce that today's presentation session is engraved with the views and sharings of our four beloved students of DBA, DCA and DHM Hospitality Department. Fine. Human Rights Watch reported that more than 1.5 billion students are out of school already. So that means they are totally detached from the education system. Widespread job and income loss along with economic insecurity among the families is likely to increase child labor and sexual exploitation. While the entire world is totally suffering for this lockdown, so the COVID-19 pandemic applications and the business strategies applied work from home strategy. Hence, this is the corporate scenario. But what about the scenario of the education sector? The education sector here, 91% of the students are totally out of education. The education sectors are facing nowadays unprecedented challenges and needs to adapt and find solutions to keep students motivated in their route of learning. So now I will like to introduce Professor Shomuna Nyogi, the assistant professor of the BBA department, who is having 2 years of academic experience and her domain area is HR and retail management. Please, Professor Nyogi, you can proceed.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for giving me the privilege to introduce today's session. I will start by saying that COVID-19 is the first truly global pandemic. It has spread faster and wider than any previous epidemic because of global connectedness. Now, but because of the same reason, it has allowed the world to fight together in this battle together. Now, a key aspect of coping up with the disease is to ensure that services are being delivered to whatever extent possible. While for professionals across industries, it has been an easier transition as many of them work on their laptops and smart devices, even in office spaces, they can now simply plug in at homes in their smart devices. Of course, what is missing is the face-to-face personal communication, which will get restored as and when things are back to normal. But for students, what is the biggest adjustment is that learning has always been in the classroom, which they cannot go to now. Besides, we have always stopped our students from using smart devices in the classroom. Now, this technology has forced them to continue their learning or the education in these smart devices. Now, here the Digital India vision of the government is emerging as a vital instrument for solving the present crisis due to COVID-19. The lockdown has accelerated adoption of digital technology although. Business houses, educational institutes, analytics, computer, data management methods and online education solutions have been forced to work in tandem and improve the quality and delivery time to handle such situations. This is an ideal time where we can experiment and deploy new tools to make education delivery meaningful to the students who can go to digital platforms to learn but cannot go to the campuses. It is a chance to be more efficient and productive while developing new and improved professional skills, knowledge through online learning and assessment. It is also a fact that use of technology in education is resulting in different concepts in the system. For instance, the move from teacher-centric education to the student-centric education. Like we have been talking about the virtual classrooms and various online technologies and tools that allow us today to make the engagement between the teacher and the student as close to real in the classroom type experience, if not exactly if possible. Going forward, these tools can also make teachers and parents meet in real time, staff management meetings more easier and cost saving while providing the necessary interactivity. One thing that I would like to discuss here while we are talking about the paradigm shift in education is the pedagogy in the digital education. We always know the technique or the pedagogy in any of the delivery mode is very important. Here in digital education, what is important is the link between the course content, educationist, technology and the course takers as well. Like democratization of technology is now an important issue comprising internet connectivity, telecom infrastructure, affordability, online system availability, desktop, every other requirements. But it is also a transparent system. Like previously we have always discriminated things, or we have always urged the students to come in the front benches or to sit in the front benches. Here in the digital platform, we see that has been demolished. There is no such discrimination. Everyone can be looked upon in the same way. To talk about our institute, we have, apart from conducting our regular classes in all of these portals, we have also taken a few of the initiatives which are the SWAM online courses for teachers and the students, UGPG MOOCs for non-technology courses, and several other from other websites as well. We have also given our students a plethora of opportunities to explore, not only in the education, but in other co-curricular activities as well. Now, looking at this challenge of colleges and schools which are being shut, Government of India as well as the state governments and private players have regularly been publishing information on various initiatives undertaken by the MHRD or the Department of Technical Education, NCERT and others to support and benefit the students. Now, going forward, the use of technology in teaching will lead to a new era wherein the best of the faculty will be available from across the globe to the student. Education quality will be gauged not just by the quality of faculty, but also will have quality of IT infrastructure, and familiarization of the faculty with digital teaching technologies will also become important post lockdown. Now, what will happen in the coming years is there will be no constraint of any location. People all across the globe with just financial support will able to access any courses worldwide. Looking forward to see this in the coming era. Thank you.
Thank you, Somona. Well, thank you, Somona. It's a nice speech from you. So, dear participants, it is being seen that online presentation, online teaching, online delivery is must and mandatory for all. Previously, it was a priority. It was a low priority, rather, for all the educational institutions. But now it has become mandatory. The educational institute, the main stakeholders are the students. So the students and the faculties are now very much habituated about the online classes. So in this regard, I would like to introduce Ishan Gupta, student of BHM fourth semester, to commence the presentation session. Ishan, please go ahead.
Thank you, ma'am, for this opportunity. Good afternoon, sir, and good afternoon, ma'am, and all the guests who have joined this training. COVID-19 has changed each and everyone's life in almost every aspect. Lifestyle, going out, having fun is no more allowed like it was. There is a huge change in economics too. People have started working from home and trying not to leave home as much as possible to maintain social distancing and precaution. Everything has been changed. And one more thing that has highly affected is our education system. My name is Krishan Gupta from BHM 6th semester, and today I will discuss about the online mode of learning, a paradigm shift in education system in post-COVID lockdown era. I request, sir, to please share my presentation. The COVID-19 has resulted in school shut all across the world. Globally, over 1.2 billion children are out of the classroom in their home right now. But this crisis shall not stop the learning and studies. Schools, colleges and institute have started finding their way out of this. The lockdown has accelerated the adoption of technology. Before pandemic, the most universities never truly embraced online education, at least not strategically. There's where online learning programs and software available, but it didn't make much difference as the traditional face-to-face learning had the power. But now the online learning is going to be a thing. Online learning is when you take courses online instead of in the physical classroom. If your schedule make it hard to attend classes, if you prefer studying at your own pace, or if you live far from the campus, online learning might be your for. With online learning, you can earn a certificate or diploma without sitting foot in the physical classroom. Work full time while you study. Set your own schedule. Study in the early morning, on your lunch break, or even in the middle of the night. Get the quality education from the renowned university without leaving your home community. It is the fact that the government of India as well as the state government through their various ministry department have created infrastructure to deliver e-learning. This includes National Knowledge Network, National Project on Technology Enhanced Learning, National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology, National Academic Depository, among these. All these enhance our ability to connect easily with institutions and enhance our access to learning resources. From instant, NKN provides high-speed network backbone to the educational institute in India. In response to significant demand, many online learning platforms are offer free access to their services, including platforms like Byju's, a Bangalore-based educational technology and online tutoring firm founded in 2011, which is now the world's most highly valued edtech company. Since announcing free live classes on its Think and Learn app, Byju's has seen a 200% increase in the number of new students using its product, according to Mrinal Mohit, the company's chief operating officer. Students are going to experience a whole new type of learning. Some research shows that on average, students retain 25 to 60% more material when learning online, compared to only 8 to 10% in the classroom. This is mostly due to the student being able to learn faster online. E-learning requires 40 to 60% less time to learn than in a traditional classroom because students can learn at their own pace, going back and rereading, skipping or accelerating through concept as they choose. Now, one question can arrive in mind that is e-learning effective in post-COVID era? And in my opinion, yes, it is because of the following feature they offer. First, the online courses. Many online universities and institutes have seen offering online courses for graduation, master studies and diploma program. This is quite beneficial as the student can learn the subject from the comfort of his home. Further, it can take up in their spare time and need not quit their jobs. This way of learning help them achieve two higher educational qualification and in turn get a promotion in job. Second, online library. Not all the books are available in local libraries or on the campus of an institute. Online libraries and other informative services as a part of general education help to solve this problem. One is accessible to unlimited set of journals and books for reference. Third, online training. Some companies and even schools and colleges may need some training for their employees or students. This training mostly involves field or practical training, but still sometimes a mere demo online by a person performing it on the other side is sufficient. This way of learning training online training reduce travel time and other expenses. Fourth and last, online revision. Revision is one of the key for daily study and examination. Revision does not need a teaching, but a constant grading of performance or updating the knowledge. Since student might forget what he heard from teacher in school or college, revision help him recall and remember that teaching. Due to this inevitable hindrance, there is a growing need to educating our youth specific to the industry. Through the traditional education system of brick and mortar classes has its own importance, online education provides more convenience than the former. First, flexibility and comfort environment. Online education provides you with a comfortable environment. You can track your performance over time and can prepare over more efficiently for the exams. You get flexible study hour while juggling with the family work and other career activities. Second, time and cost effective. Online education is very promising in saving travel fare and the time to commute. It also saves your efficiency to work more and deliver much time to pursue other curricular activity, which is impossible due to the offline education system. Point number three, preferred courses. Through e-learning, any student can choose the course of his or her preference. Many certification online courses are available in India. Courses like MBA, MSc, MCA, BA Honours, Executive MBA, Retail and Digital Marketing can all be taken up online in India. Institutes like IIT Kanpur, IIM Bangalore, NEET, IGNU, Khan Academy and many more offer online courses in India. Many employers are recognizing the importance of online education and recruiting employers graduate from online education courses. Last and fourth, efficient accessibility. Learning knows no age. From a school student to an age person, anyone can study any preferred course. The only thing needed are the ability of smart accessories and a good speed internet connection. You don't need to commute from anywhere or leave far away from family and friends to pursue an education in order to achieve success in career. It allows women, downtrodden classes and deprived people to achieve education and challenge the traditional ideology and norms by breaking the barrier both geographically and socially. There's a lot of things that are going to be changed. No more going out to schools and colleges to attend lectures, no traveling, no spending extra money. Also, students can save their money by avoiding many fees typically by campus-based education, including lab fees, computing fees, parking, hostel, etc. Students now get admission to their favorite college even if it's too far. So at last we can conclude that online education saves time, money and energy. Through it, you can gain a proliferation of effective information while sitting at home. Through online diploma courses, students can increase their qualification and enhance their career opportunity. It also beneficial to physically disabled people who can now pursue degree and build their career through online learning effortlessly. It is a fact that online education is a 53% cheaper than offline education. And I would like to end this presentation with a quote, learning is not the product of teaching. Learning is the product of activity of learners by John Hall. Thank you, everyone.
Well, thank you, Kishan. Kishan is our BHM 6th semester student who shared his views very fruitfully. And from his views, it can be aptly said that laptops, digital deliveries, digital books are the three key attributes by which today online education is being carried on. Okay, now in this regard, I want to share a few data with you. On 27th March, UNESCO dedicated a second COVID-19 webinar where two specific points are being mentioned. The first of all, learning continuity, and the second one, about 163 million teachers are being affected from 165 countries of the world. So fine, in this regard, I would like to introduce and welcome our next presenter, Shilajit Ray from BBA second semester. Shilajit, please continue.
Thank you, madam, for introducing me. Good evening to my respected principal, sir, HOD madam, coordinator madam, and everybody present here. This is Shilajit Ray of BBA second semester, going to share my views on shifts in teaching learning system in pre and post COVID-19 lockdown, learners view. Here I would like to discuss about the impact of COVID-19 on Indian educational strategies. So I would request sir to please display my PPT. Thank you very much, sir. So let me start with the introductory view of this presentation. The prevailing condition of COVID-19 infection have changed the global lifestyle of human beings living on this earth. A drastic change have been noticed in the imparting of education. The bar diagram on this slide represents the gradual rise in figure of COVID-19 infection from March to June. So the next is the impact of teaching in pre-COVID lockdown. Generally, we mean underlying meaning of offline mode of classes deals with the liaison between the student and the teacher. In some educational institutions, smart classes and extra classes were also held to pull up the weaker students. The parents could also discuss the loopholes of their words with the teachers. Moving on to the next slide. Educational institutions in India are ensuring learning never stops amid COVID-19 with the virtual classes. COVID-19 infection have put mankind to a critical and challenging situation. Life came to a standstill all of a sudden. In this situation, the regular classes of all schools and colleges were completely suspended. As per directives of UGC and HRD Ministry, schools and colleges under various boards and universities started giving virtual classes through different online platforms and as well as television. The ideas that are reflected from the pie chart given in this slide, that how present technology is being used, that is 14% for the telephone, 38% for the television, and 48% for the internet approximately. Let's move to the next slide. Effect of Cyclone Amphan on virtual classes. Now, the Cyclone Amphan was an obstacle in the process of virtual classes. The Alipur Weather Forecasting Office gave a red alert and fishermen were forbidden from going to the sea. As a result of this, the students were unable to attend online classes due to the total disruption in power supply, internet services, etc. However, those services were restored within a week. The next idea that I will focus is impact of teaching in post-COVID lockdown. It was indeed a great move towards digital India, that is from traditional to the technological technique of teaching. The lockdown period taught us how to work without silly excuses. The strategy of switching over virtual classes was a very appropriate footstep. These virtual classes require very few resources, such as a desktop or a laptop or a tablet or even a smartphone can be used in this regard. Moving on to the next slide. Whether it is benefit to the student or not, it improves technological intelligence of an individual. The teachers played an important part here by continuing classes to complete the syllabuses on time. They tried their level best to clear the doubts and queries of all the students. Last but not the least, online classes in this crisis period was seen as a new paradigm in education. E-learning is going to give a major impact on education and herald the arrival of new normal. Thus, I am concluding my presentation here. Hope everyone enjoyed it. Thank you all for listening and giving me the opportunity to present in this webinar.
Well, thank you, Shilaji. He is a student from BBA second semester and he very nicely posted all his views and shared all his knowledge and views regarding online teaching. Well, next I want to introduce Nandini Das, student of DCA second semester, to share her views. Nandini, please proceed.
Sir, my presentation, please. Thank you, sir. Post-COVID-19, the world will get a new way to utilize its fuel. There will be changes and the impact of the pandemic have a diverse effect on education sector. Moving to the next slide, I'll explain about the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on education. Firstly, in this lockdown situation, some unintended strain affected the healthcare system. Secondly, the current rapid and forced adoption of distance learning will likely lead to permanent changes. Next, access to the technology and materials needed to continue learning while educational institutions are closed is desperately unequal. And lastly, in order to contribute to the mitigation of this crisis, we propose a set of multi-layered strategies. Moving to the next slide, I'll explain about the strategies of the education sector in pre- and post-COVID era. The strategies are online education, remote learning, online micro-courses, e-library, e-notes, e-quiz. So, online education has brought a lot to the learning table. E-learning or remote learning poses a challenge to both the teachers and students over technology and access. Software and applications like Zoom, Microsoft Teams are the learning providers. Not only that, teachers are doing an excellent job by providing e-notes and some other study materials via e-library and also conducting some e-quizzes. Now, I'll explain about major changes in education sector through the next slide. In this post-COVID-19, some major changes are expected to take place in education sector. First, blended learning. The classroom will be supplemented by online coursework. This way, students may be required to physically attend classes on fewer days and will be free to study at their own pace. So, blended learning will become a reality. Second, the use of artificial intelligence will help personalize the learning experience for every student. It is easier to collaborate and gives more control over learning strategies, and it helps to develop our technical skills. Third, technology will be used effectively to reduce the time spent by teachers on tasks such as paper setting, evaluating, and guarding. And at last, interactive online programs are playing an important role to keep students engaged with their education and skills. So, my last slide is about the responses to the crisis. We have to examine the readiness and choose the most relevant tools. First, we need to fight for inclusive education. Inclusive education is opportunities for those who are living in seclusion and disadvantaged economic conditions. Distance learning can bridge these gaps. Second, we have to protect the data privacy and data security. Third, we have to provide support to teachers and parents with resources and digital tools in order to teach children about their rights. Fourth, we should take the measures to develop distance learning rules and monitor student learning process for those who are coming from low-income groups. And lastly, by creating communities and enhancing that connection between students, teachers are helping them to develop their skills. So, this pandemic is clearly a sign of changing times and human behavior. It is also an event that has given rise to push digitalization in the education sector. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Nandini, for your wonderful views. So in this respect, one and only question cropped up in our mind that how will the COVID-19 pandemic alter the future of teaching and learning? Now in this respect, the very first answer that we get is that some schools and colleges will be closed or merged. Secondly, the most vulnerable of tuition-dependent institutions, particularly the ones which already are facing demographically driven declines in demand will be the hardest hit by the pandemic. So in merging all these new areas of some crucial attributions of online teaching, I would like to invite Shoptanu Pal of VBA second semester to share his presentation. Shoptanu, please proceed.
Good afternoon, respected teacher and my dear friend. Myself, Shoptanu Pal, student of VBA second semester from Nopanib Institute of Management Studies. Before starting my student's presentation, I would like to thank all the teachers in charge for giving me this wonderful opportunity to speak on today's topic, that is shifts in teaching and learning system in pre and post COVID lockdown. So therefore, may I request that to please share my PPT presentation. Firstly, the current scenario. Sometime in the second week of March, central and state governments across the country began to shut down schools and colleges temporarily as a measure to contain the spread of the novel coronavirus. It is close to 4 months now, and there is no certainty when they will reopen. This is a crucial time for the education sector, as final examination, admission, entrance tests of various universities and competitive examinations are all held during this period. As the days passed by with no immediate solution to stop the outbreak of COVID-19, school and university closures will not only have a short-term impact on the continuity of learning more than 285 million young learners in India, but also endanger far-reaching economic and societal consequences. The structure of schooling and learning, including teaching and assessment methodologies, was the first to be affected by these closures. Only a handful of private schools could adopt online teaching methods. Their low-income private and government school counterparts, on the other hand, have completely shut down for not having access to e-learning solutions. The students, in addition to the missed opportunities for learning, no longer have access to healthy meals during this time and are subject to economic and social stress. The pandemic has significantly disrupted the higher education sector as well, which is a critical determinant of country's economic future. A large number of Indian students enroll in universities abroad, especially in countries worst affected by the pandemic, like USA, UK, and Australia. Many such students have now been barred from leaving this country. If the situation persists in the long run, a decline in the demand for international higher education is expected. The bigger concern, however, on everybody's mind is the effect of the disease on the employment rate. Recent graduates in India are fearing withdrawal of job offers from corporates because of the current situation. The Center for Monitoring Indian Economics estimates on unemployment shot up from 8.4% in mid-March to 23% in early April, and the urban unemployment rate to 30.9%. Needless to say, the pandemic has transformed the centuries-old stop-stop teaching model to one driven by technology. This disruption in the delivery of education is pushing policymakers to figure out how to drive engagement at scale while ensuring inclusive e-learning solutions and tackling the digital divide. A multi-pronged strategy is necessary to manage the crisis and build a resilient Indian education system in the long term. Digital learning can solve many problems, which has been part of our brick and mortar classroom system for ages. Now, what are the opportunities faced? Firstly, affordability. The biggest issue that many students face is the lack of opportunities and resources, while some of them discontinue their studies due to monetary issues. Students who are interested in learn and gather knowledge on different in-demand courses usually face difficulty, as traditional coaching centers are not well equipped. Relocating to another city for study requires economic stability, which everyone does not possess. In such case, digital learning comes to the rescue, as it does not ask you to travel anywhere to reach the education institution. Secondly, outreach. Digitalization in India led to the development of technologies and provided the students with an opportunity to study through any device at any time. Now getting 75% attendance marked on the teacher's register is not essential to get a job. Digital learning ensures that the syllabus must be parallel to global education. Moreover, digital learning is not bounded by geography or time. The digital learning courses are self-paced and target every individual who wants to enhance their knowledge. Thirdly, flexible learning environment. Live learning events require that those participate align their schedules to the training calendar. Digital learning eliminates this because the course can be accessed anytime, anywhere. The combination of multimedia and instructional design can produce a very rich learning experience. Digital learning includes all sorts of online technology. If some of the tools that allow collaboration and conversation can be incorporated, knowledge can be captured for future learners. In present education system, if you need a refresher, you need to take good notes. Otherwise, refresher is not possible. That's not the case with digital learning. Ideally, one continue to access to the online content and resources to brush up on what one had learned. Next, active and engaging. Learning through the conventional methods becomes a little boring if done in a monotonous flow. Online learning through mobile, laptop, or tablet makes users more engaged in the learning process. The method is highly dynamic and can be manipulated accordingly to the requirements, timing, and priorities, hence giving one the ability to develop better learning ability. Lastly, unlimited classroom capacity. Digital learning is accessible for 24 hours a day. This is a very useful option for professionals and other persons who are busy in their day job. Managing an online course and work schedule according to the daily routine becomes easier with digital learning. There is no pressure to meet deadlines. Being able to access almost all sorts of information without worrying about the fact that it is going to be a crowded environment ensures a better level of understanding and productivity. So these were the opportunities. Now coming to the drawbacks. Lockdown has paused the exam cycle. Different institutes conduct exams and entrances during this time period, but all those exams are postponed or are being conducted online. Closure of educational institutes has put forward numerous issues affecting access to education due to lack of classes, as well as broader socio-economic issues, such as the technology divide between the rich and the poor in the educational sector. Sometimes as well, slow internet connection causes many disruptions. So to sum up, I would like to conclude by saying that both physical and digital learning can be used to achieve the same goals. Which one you choose depends on the logistics of delivering your training as well as the subject matter being taught. However, in a more and more globalized workplace, live online lessons are becoming an increasingly obvious choice for any professional development program. At last, I would like to suggest that every particular should shoulder their work with complete safety measures. Stay safe. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Shoptanu, for your nice presentation. So now in this regard, at the end of the session, I would like to request our respected principal, sir, Dr. Ghosh, to please continue the session and to share his important views with us. Please, sir.
Good afternoon to you all. First of all, I would like to welcome to all the participants, those who have joined in this webinar. Organizers, Somuna Madam, who has delivered the introductory speech, Sarda Madam, and Anupam sir also is there, who will be delivering these concluding remarks, and also the organizers like Anisha Madam, then Kaveri Madam, Shumon, Mahendra sir, Juhib. So all the organizers, those who have joined here to organize this program successfully. So as far as this online teaching learning is concerned, actually, it has become, as it has been mentioned by the Somona Madam, it has been compulsory, it has been mandatory for us to conduct this online teaching learning. Yes, it's a pandemic that has been announced on 11th of March by World Health Organization. So that because of this pandemic situation of COVID-19, this teaching learning has become, it has been shifted into the online or digital. It has been a compulsory, it has, otherwise either the learners or the teacher or the teaching learning will not be completed, that is why. So it has been compulsory, and this, since it's a learner's view, so from learner's perspective, learners always talk about, yes, this online teaching learning is better because it saves their time. They don't have to come to the institution. They can access any time. Yes, there are several merits. There are several demerits also of this online teaching. The demerits, if we highlight that what the last speaker has said, this internet is one of the major problem. Major problem, all the learners, they are not having good bandwidth of internet. They are not always having the good device to attend this webinar. This digital classes and all. So there are many difficulties. All the learners, they might not have. So if they do not have, they will be suffering. They won't be getting the fruits of the benefit online learning benefit. On the other hand, it is, or if I say another issue also, say the learners, when they are in physically present in the classroom, one experienced teacher can understand, can read their face, they can understand whether this particular student has understood this particular topic or not. So here in online, it is very difficult for the teachers to understand whether the student is in active mode or not. They are attending. They have participated in this class, attending the class, but it is difficult to understand whether, always, it is difficult to understand to mark on the participant's page also that whether this particular student is present or he is in active mode or inactive mode, or it is difficult while teaching, difficult to ask always the student. So there are many demerits also. Anyway, this, since it has been compulsory for us to conduct online teaching, and that has been compulsory for the students to take the education online, it's actually shift, or you can say it's a paradigm shift due to this COVID situation, pandemic COVID situation. So that is actually shift from traditional teaching to online teaching. It's a paradigm shift. So there is no alternative here during now unless we go for this online, because otherwise this learners will be suffering from this. But since this situation shifts has occurred in this system, therefore this system will continue, and we will be adapting this situation as the situation moves on. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your nice views. So in continuation of the future of teaching, learning, again, actually it can be focused that if we look far and hard enough into our post-secondary, post-pandemic landscape, we can glimpse some reasons for optimism. Nowhere is the higher education post-COVID-19 future as positive or as interesting as in the realm of teaching and learning. So in this aspect, I would like to introduce our academic coordinator of Nopani Group of Institutions, Sri Anupam Das, to continue the concluding speech. Sir, please continue.
Thank you, Sharada ma'am. First of all, I'd like to congratulate Kishan, Shilajit, Nandini and Shatarnav Pal for their wonderful presentation. And I also like to congratulate our NIMS teaching and non-teaching members for conducting wonderful series of webinars, which is so is filled with information. Now come to the conclusion, this COVID-19 has taught us few things, and today I learned really something very good and something very new, which is like the term which is called technological intelligence. Yes, the COVID-19 situation has made us technologically very sound, and now we are more technological friendly. than ever before. Secondly, this COVID-19 situation has also made a change in the society mindset that previously the degree or the diploma or the certificate which a student acquired through online is not acceptable socially. Now, this UGC as well as the Ministry of HRD has made it mandatory for all the colleges to teach online. So this certificate which we will, or the degree or the mark sheet which we'll gain after this learning process which come through online and which will be acceptable in future also. So there is a shift in the thinking of mindset also socially, and in this online education is now being accepted universally. Now if we see from education institutions point of view, yes, it is a challenging work for all the educational institution to shift to the new technology, and I thank to Principal Sir and NIMS team, because we are one of the first few colleges which started this online teaching at the very initial stage. I think in WBUT we are the first which starts the online teaching mode, and for the benefit of the student, and it's not very easy. It's not time saving for teacher as well, as one of your friends told that it saves time for the teachers, but as a administrative coordinator and I used to teach, I can understand the teacher had to work a lot, had to work really hard to change from a classroom mode to an online mode. Because in online mode, everything is new. You have to prepare your new everything, all the lectures in from the very scratch, and you have to change your teaching strategy also in online mode. And it is not very cakewalk for the institution as well, because online teaching doesn't come cheap. It is costly first of all from the education institution point of view. It involves lot of work hours from educational institution point of view, as well as it invites lot of criticism from the student point of view. Still we are facing so much criticism from many quarters of the students. Some students are criticizing us because we are asking them for the overdue fees. Some students are criticizing us because we are not including them in some of our classes. So these are the few things which are the negative from the institution point of view, because we have to run the show and we have to pay our teachers, we have to pay our expenses, and everything we have to do as well as we have to teach. So this COVID-19 situation or this pandemic has teach us lot of things. We are now learning, the institution is learning. And I think new method of teaching and new innovation we will see in future also, which can make this virtual learning more acceptable and more friendlier than ever before. Well, I want to thank all of you for joining this wonderful session. Thank you, Principal Sir. Thank you, Organizer Sarada Madam. Thank you, Shobana Madam. And our back-end team, Joheb Sir, Kaveri Madam, I'd like to thank all of you for organizing such a wonderful webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful views. So one point we can add, that now also in this post-pandemic period, post-COVID-19 period, learning is in continuity. We will continue our learning despite of several loopholes and hurdles that we are facing in our way. So at last, I will share three predictions for how our post-pandemic pedagogy will be altered across the higher education system. Firstly, blended learning will dramatically increase. Secondly, online education will be strategic priority at every institution. So in this regard, I would like to cite the example of our own institution, that is Nopani Institute of Management Studies, who already started the online teaching from the day one only, and pose a remarkable output in this regard by merging institutional resilience and academic continuity. Last but not the least, existing and potential OPM, that is online program management partnerships, will be regularly re-strategized and rethought. Hence, the process is a dynamic process. So finally, let's wrap up today's session. Hope all of you have enjoyed today's session. And before ending up, let me tell you, please fill up the Google form for the quiz, attempt the quiz, gain e-certificates, and link already being shared to your email and also in the chat box. Please go through it and do the quiz and attempt the quiz also. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.